we are going to do buffer overflow 1, and let's see. So we are told that this challenge launches an instance on demand, so let's launch that. Yeah, we have a functionality where we can download the program, so yeah, so we have both binaries here. I have given this the I have set the executable bits on this binary. So let's check what type of a binary it is. As you can see here, it's a 32-bit least significant byte binary, and it is not stripped, so we will find all the symbol functions there. It's dynamically linked, so it has the shared objects and all that. So to check the shared objects, you can like just use that, and you can see the linker and the libc. We can check the security of this binary, and we can see that no canaries are found. It has partial reroll, so this is relocation read only. Yeah, and next, all the not executable bits are not set, so basically we can press our shellcode on the stack and execute it. No PIE, so basically the position independent executable is not there, it's disabled, so the binary, we already know the base where the binary will always run from. It has read write and executable bits, so this is like the same with NX. This, so we can read the source code, and we get there are two variables, global variables. One is the buffer size, which is set to 32, and the flag size, which is set to 64. There's a win function, and if we see here, we are using gets to get our input to the buff variable, which is set to 32. So this is a buffer array size of 32 characters. Using gets is risky because you cannot determine how much will enter to this buff variable. From here, you can see that we are calling the van function, and so I guess we need to take control of the instruction pointer and maybe jump to the winner function and get the flag. So since we know how this is working, we can like just start with a script first. Remember, the essence of a capture the flag challenge is your speed, so let's practice on speed. Yeah, so having set the context, now we can like just define the process. So this is just to start the binary and all that. Another thing we can do is just set the checksec to false, so that we don't have to be displayed the message of the security. So another thing, you saw this is a 32-bit binary, so when you overflow the RIP of a 32-bit binary, it will give us the overflow. Yeah, and you can see here we are jumping to this instruction, and we got a buffer overflow here. So yes, you can get that is 44. So we will go back to the script and change that. So that will do the same job. So the next thing we want to do is craft our payload. First, we need to set the address of winner function. So that will be elf.symbols.win. And we are told to create a flag.txt, so that works. Yes, and we get the flag there. To make the script efficient, we can try to use something like log. Yeah, and we get the flag there. See you next time.